What's Hi, it's me, Phoenician Sailor, and I'm recording tonight to give you all a simple but hopefully effective ASMR video that'll help you get to sleep. I want to dive right in and just start with the sounds. I will be whispering or softly speaking from ear to ear as I make various sounds with various objects, including a few donated by our eviscerated friend back there. Brief moment, brief bit of channel news before we jump in. For those of you who follow me on Patreon or Facebook or Twitter, which if you don't, links below, will know that I've posted things and I'm working on things that are in the pike, so to speak. And I just want to reassure you all, not that anybody's champing at the bit for any of this, but I reassure you all that those things are still in progress, but they take longer. I've recently acquired a new camera, which I'm using. It's the first time I'm using it for a video. So I'm hoping that it goes as well as I expect it to. Some of the things that I had done on some of those videos, I want to redo. So that's part of the reason for the delay. The other part of the reason for the delay is just the past few weeks have been particularly anxiety-inducing and demoralizing for many reasons that I don't want to go into or talk about in this video. But you're a human being living in the same world that I'm living in, so have a guess if you like. But I'm trying to come out of that, get over that hump, and get inspired again. I saw a message, a tweet from ASMR Node, who's really good, does really good role plays, really great at improv and accents, and really funny guy. So if you haven't checked out his channel, please do. But I saw a tweet from him where he mentioned that he was having trouble finding inspiration lately. And I don't blame him. Inspiration comes when it does. I, for one, would like to make more videos and more directed videos, and more simple videos, and videos that would not affect the output of the more involved stuff, but would be something like this that I can still do without interrupting the flow of these parallel projects. So, having said all that, tonight, my stomach will not cooperate when I'm making a video. Having said all that, tonight is a straight ASMR video, and I hope you enjoy it. So let's get started. These are the IsoFlex balls. They are part of what I'm calling the Five Below set of ASMR objects. I don't know, you can see behind me, you probably can't hear if I step out of frame for a moment. I have a lot of racks filled with stuff, like camera stuff, and some of those racks are have ASMR objects on them that are kind of categorized, and I found that I've gotten a lot of things from Five Below, which has been great. If you don't know what Five Below is, it is a dollar store, except instead of everything costing under a dollar, everything costs under $5. And you might be surprised at, if you haven't been, at the kinds of things that you can find for under $5. Don't hold out for anything of super high quality or enduring value. I'm sure these will shortly burst or leak in the sand or whatever's in them will come out, but these were only, I think, like $3 for the two of them together. And they're technically stress balls, but they don't do a lot for me. The act of squishing them doesn't do a lot for my stress. The sound I find pretty comforting. You have to forgive my creaking finger bones if you hear them. You also have to forgive my stomach, unlike Mr. Viscera there, or viscera. I do have intestines, and they love to make noise at inappropriate times. I suppose that's just association. They probably make noise at appropriate times too, and I just don't care when that happens. This is part of the issue. Too much introspection and the paralysis that can come from it. I like that a lot. I'm going to do that again. Squeeze them together. Pull them apart. And one of my favorite things about ASMR videos, or making ASMR videos, is discovering things as I go. Flex Balls, part of the Five Below collection. I have a table here with just a bunch of things on it. These were part of a craft set that I bought. And I noticed that they had a particular interesting noise when you squeeze them. It's pretty subtle, so I hope that it's actually coming through. Like the kinds of things they used to build Muppets. And these were also gotten at Five Below. I don't get reimbursed by Five Below for saying that. In fact, if you want to yourself, if you're an anxious type, you have social anxiety, go to Five Below around Saturday around 11 a.m. because it's hectic. At least the one near me is. And exercise in patience. Dealing with others, just getting through the line. I've been very happy with these microphones and the microphone preamp that I've been using. houses of two Muppets. Background in metal. Whenever I tap out a rhythm, it tends to be triplets. It's not the equestrian in me. Says, relax. Opaque's resigned. Of wood. I also have two pink sticks. Sounds like, to a lesser extent, but certainly not something I've ever heard up here like this. Not even during Snowmageddon. three Snowmageddons since I moved. Well, that's actually getting quite loud. It might. This video might go in the bin. Iron Maiden. I did not pick pink and blue for any gendered reasons. Just coincidence. squid, all right, with big squeezed. Camera lost focus on me. -1.5 star. This house was built in the 50s, I believe. Brick. I'm not worried. I hear something that came as part of a crafts kit. They're just, you know, wire with fabric, like pipe cleaners, but the pattern is kind of like a tiger tail. But I noticed that when I rubbed my nail against a wire beneath, perceived by my viewers as a trigger person. But I would love feedback on any of the stuff that worked in particular. In fact, before I end this video, I'm going to do one trigger that came about as a request based on something that was inadvertent. It was just kind of stumbled upon. It's not new. Lots of other people have done it, but in the video where I did it, I didn't intend for it to be a trigger. It just happy accident. But in this video, I do intend it to be a trigger, so hopefully it doesn't backfire. months ago, I watched the Netflix series Mindhunters. I wasn't blown away by it. I wanted to like it more than I did. I liked parts of it, but I felt like large parts of it were fairly dull. But it did spark enough interest in me to read the book by John Douglas. And if you've seen the series, you'll know he's the first FBI agent, first person on any sort of police force to begin the use of profiling to help narrow the pool of suspects when it comes to serial killing was what, you know, he focused on, but of course profiling has since been used in lots of other ways, and many of them negative, because of our implicit biases. I'll tell you, the book is more interesting. Scoffed at for so long, and by so many, that when he was finally vindicated, it was too late. He had that chip on his shoulder. He was right. Sort of stuff. I'm a horror fan and read a lot of true crime and crime fiction. I find Works. Fantasy dice, but they're not. The sound of having any hard candy in your mouth. It's kind of similar to that. This pillow.